galaxies, ruler of planet Plastico!
All hail Zork! All hail Zork! All hail Zork!
Silence, my aliens!
All hail Zork, he's a dork. All hail Zork, he's a dork. He's got legs just like a stork. Hey, if Zork's the ruler of planet Plastico, does that mean he's a plastic ruler? Plastic ruler, get it?
Enough, you idiots. We are here on a serious mission. My mission, my destiny, is to rule the entire universe!
Your despicableness, our scanners detect the approaching source of a signal.
Who would have thought that this puny planet in this dead-end star system would contain so much beautiful plastic?
Your Talbanus, our ship is in position and we're ready to begin phase one.
Oh no, we're not going back to phase one.
That was strange.
Begin phase one. Unleash my dark troopers onto this pathetic planet.
My lord, this is a little bit awkward, but, well,
Spit it out! What is the matter?
Well, there is no armies. They're all a bit too small.
Well, now I know what it's like working in reception. But what do you mean, no army? How can this be? I am Zork, the destroyer of worlds. Where are my armies? I demand to know, where are my armies?
Up your sleeves, get it? Armies, sleeves, it's killing me.
No, believe me, I'll be doing that if you don't pack it in with those ridiculous and idiotic jokes. Now, where were we? Oh yes, where are my armies? Alien Van Tam and Alien Witty, explain this immediately.
Well, your monstrousness, to be honest, being the almighty Zork, the destroyer of worlds, I am sure you'll already know the answer. But if I don't explain now, no one in the audience will have a clue what is going on in the rest of the show.
Too late. I've already lost the plot. This happens every year. I blame the writers.
As I was saying, the reason your deadly army of clone troopers are a little, how should I put it, vertically challenged is simple.
Graph one, please. To manufacture an army of deadly alien dark trooper clones, we first need a mountain of plastic. You see, the plastic is turned into flakes, and then we feed the flakes to the growing clones.
Feed the plastic flakes to the clones?
Well, yes, we call them clone flakes.
Next slide, please. As you can see from this graph, we started off with an army of very small clone troopers. And although we expected height to peak at 12 weeks, it has not. To create fully sized clone troopers, we really need to unflatten this line and reach a considerable peak.
The science strongly suggests that one ball of clone flakes, three times a day, for a period of 12 weeks, will be sufficient to produce that peak and so deliver the army of fully grown clone troopers, which we need.
Graph 3, please. Looking at the start of our journey, we had a substantial supply of clone flakes. But, as this graph clearly shows, while we are journeying from here to here, the number of clone flakes has decreased rapidly.
We can't ignore the science. Recent data clearly shows that someone has eaten our whole supply of clone flakes.
What kind of idiot would do such a thing?
That kind of idiot!
Whoa, I was hungry!
To create our clone army, the data tells us one simple message. We need to get more flakes into more mouths.
Our flake production team, Plaster Zeneca, has the technology, but slide four please, to make more clone flakes, we need more plastic.
Thank you, Alien Van Tam and Alien Witty. Very enlightening. Well, it is clear that we must follow the science and find more plastic. If only we knew where on earth all of it was being made.